Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. D Knuckles here. How we doing? It's pretty late right now, and I'm in my garage, so you have to excuse my mess. I got some tubes over here that we're going to be working on some rocket projects with, some rocket motors and such. What I wanted to talk to you guys about is my slash 4x4 GoPro mount project that I've been working on to put my GoPro here on the slash 4x4 bumper. It's kind of a difficult project to do. You might think it's kind of easy, but it's kind of hard, so to speak. I kind of want to get a shot where you get the GoPro shooting the truck from the front end. You know, you can see with monster trucks like the E-Max, the Savages, the Revos, you know, it's really good. They get some great footage. Slash 4x4 is a little difficult because you have the bumper, how it's angled right here. Now, I did shoot some video with this pole here that I did, or put the GoPro right up here. I used my roll bar mount and kind of aimed it down. You know, it works great. You know, I get a really cool shot, but I don't get to see a lot of the workings of the front end, the suspension. So what I did was, one of the comments in that video where I did the test footage using this angled upwards, I had a fellow by the name of RC Trucking 3-Speed, I believe that's his YouTube handle, his name, said that I should use a 45 degree angle. It never even occurred to me, a 45 degree angle. We have lots of PVC here in my house, you know, we're always making marshmallow guns or other different things, you know, the kids always want to make things, so we always got PVC around because it's cheap. So what I did was went and picked up a 45 degree angle right here. It's for a half inch piping. So I drilled through the bumper, drilled at an angle, and got it in there. Got it looking what I thought was pretty good flesh. You have to part everything because it's not real tightened down right now. It's a little wobbly, a little loose because I'm waiting to get everything worked out before I start to cement everything together. But I put the half inch piping in the elbow and the GoPro. I don't even remember what the GoPro even weighs. But it's heavy enough that it kind of weighs the front end down a little bit. And so in one of the test videos I did, I had this all set up and it was bouncing all over the place. I didn't have the zip tie then at that point. And it was just bouncing all over the place, and this would dig into the ground and flip the truck over a couple different times. So the second time I did, what I did was I put the zip tie in. What that did was kind of raise the front end a little bit, but then it pulls the front end bumper underneath the body so the body sticks over it. I don't really like that because then it kind of pulls the truck down a little bit, so it kind of defeats the purpose. And this doesn't dig in quite so much, but it still digs in. So we're still looking on some ideas. I think I'm going to bring the actual mount in a little bit closer. I think I might put in a T-connection right here, bring another piece of PVC up this way, and raise the body a little bit. I'm still debating, but if I put another piece of PVC right here, then I can use my GoPro mount or another mount to fit right here and get some other shots. So that way, if I use an elbow at the bottom of it, it won't so much dig in, it'll just kind of skim across. I don't know, I'm still working on some ideas for that. Another thing I'm doing is I'm meeting up with another guy who's really good with fabrication, loves to work with metal. And what we're going to do is we're going to work on a mount that we could, out of metal, that we could fabricate that will connect to the bumper or possibly even to the chassis and come up underneath. We're going to look for something that might be kind of cool, something that's kind of economical. But we're looking for a DIY, and this is what I came up with, PVC pipe. Only costs like a dollar for an 8-foot section and connectors. One other thing that I did was, this actually was an elbow for, it was a 45 degree elbow for 3/4 inch tubing. What I did was, I took my Dremel tool, kind of hollowed it out right in there, so that way it would fit right over this half inch 45 degree elbow connector. And what that did was actually raise it up a little bit more. And then I just cut off the extra piece right here. I'm probably going to cut off some more. And then, you know, that kind of what that did was angle the elbow up a little bit more. Now I'm going to work on something else that I can do to kind of bring that basically up a little bit more, make it a little bit more secure. Still looking for ideas. So if you guys have any ideas on how to improve this, post them up. Make a video. You know, that's what the RC community is about. It's about helping each other out. Now, I may go with this route. I may go a different route. I may even come up with a few different ideas. But this is what we're working on right now. So I just thought I'd let you know where I'm at on this. Another thing that I wanted to talk to you guys about is the comment. It was made by Bleep RC Trucking 3-Speed. So he's got a couple videos on his channel right now. Go ahead, check them out and give him some props. So in the meantime, share your thoughts. Thrash it, bash it, break it. No regrets.